unboxing and trying out the new, kind of new, not so new, Anchor Soundcore 2. Soundcore 2 by Anchor. I bought it from Amazon. It was, how much was it? It was 30 bucks. And I also, before, like a week before, or 2 weeks before, more like 3 weeks before, I actually bought the Soundcore 3 because my big master plan was, it's already open. I don't know if I rigged it or, I mean, I don't mind. No one cares. So here's the small story. For one, I wanted a speaker that was a very nice Bluetooth speaker. I only would own one Bluetooth speaker. Why? Because in the past I bought the Soundcore as my first proper Bluetooth speaker. I had like a very small pop-up speaker before, which was very good, but it didn't have Bluetooth. And then actually, like within the last 10 years, Bluetooth speakers actually became really good. Before this, Bluetooth speakers basically were crap boxes, you could say. So now I bought, first of all, the Soundcore 1, and it sounded amazing. Then I got the UE Boom, because this was like a dream, and I just kept it. Originally, I was like, buy it on Amazon Prime Day and then just resell it for double the price, because usually it's double the price compared to Prime Day. Then I got the Soundcore 1, or I had the Soundcore 1. I also had the UE Boom, and I wanted a solution for also being able to plug in my guitar and just amplify my guitar a little bit. And I actually just tried these Bluetooth speakers because I thought, like, these are proper speakers. Why don't they work? They are also kind of active, which means they also amplify the signal at least a little bit. And most of these have also audio plugins, so just headphone jack ins, basically, not headphone jack, but audio jack ins inputs. So now it worked on the Soundcore 1. I tried it. It also worked on the JBL Go, for example. It didn't really work. It kind of did work on the UE Boom 2, but the problem was that the latency was just too big. Therefore, I was like, I just sell. And the Soundcore 1 was not a good enough Bluetooth speaker for being my one Bluetooth speaker, and also my one stereo whenever I am basically out and about. Not really out and about, but somewhere where I just want to live, for example. And I just want to take a stereo with me, because these are just things that keep you from actually moving or traveling somewhere. So now I was like, what if I had only one speaker that additionally, this is something I discovered recently, would also act as, so basically the Soundcore, due to its form, acts as a perfect, not monitor stand, but notebook stand that actually keeps your notebook at an angle, which allows for very smooth typing experiences. Now, the problem obviously was the Soundcore 1 was not good enough as a speaker on its own. The Soundcore, the UE Boom 2 had too much latency, but it sounded great as a Bluetooth speaker. But it also wasn't black, and I just wanted to standardize everything in black, if it was possible. And I also wanted to USB-C everything, if possible, because then in the future I wouldn't have to hassle around with micro USB cables, because they tend to break quite easily. And also USB-C everything, and Thunderbolt, and notebook, and charging with Thunderbolt. So therefore, I thought about the Soundcore 2 for quite some time, but I didn't upgrade, because I already had the UE Boom. Then recently I just sold the Soundcore 1 for like 20 bucks, and I actually bought it like a few years ago for 23 bucks, which was kind of a deal, I guess. So basically now to the Soundcore 2. What's in the box? It's not the most linear explanation here, but here's the box. So, I mean, it's just a box. It's fully IPX7 waterproof, 24 hours playback time. So the Soundcore 1 actually had pretty much 24 hours. I can actually, from my own experience, it just never went out. And also, it has a very intelligent standby mode, which means it just goes on standby, but it actually still is on. So therefore, if you just press play again, it just is there. Whereas the UE Boom just goes off after, it turns off after quite some time. Now, it also has Bluetooth, and it's called Soundcore. What else is in the box? This thing, also this thing, which says, thanks for choosing Anchor. And now, let's actually take a look inside. So there is obviously another charging cable. Why another? Because I just unpacked something else. There was also a charging cable in there. These are actually very nice cables. I also use for phone charging, but obviously very often these cables don't have a huge power output, which is kind of sad, because then you cannot use them for charging your notebook, for example, which you could theoretically with USB-C. So you just plug in any charger to the wall, and then you just, or into a socket, and then you can just charge your notebook, which works still, but not as nice if you don't have huge power. I just leave it in there because it just might break, and then within 30 days I can just send it back. So now to the Soundcore 3. This is the Soundcore 2, but I actually had the Soundcore 3 like for quite some time yet now. And why did I buy the Soundcore 3? Because it obviously was the newest edition, and it also had decent reviews. It was like 45 or 50 bucks, 50 euros, and quite expensive if you compare it to the 23 bucks of the Soundcore 1. I bought actually the UE Boom for 80 bucks back a few years ago, so it was a quite expensive speaker, but the Soundcore is kind of a budget speaker. Not really, because it's not that good, but the Soundcore 1 just wasn't as good as the UE Boom. Then I sold the Soundcore 1, I bought the Soundcore 3, and I realized it didn't have an audio in, which is kind of sad, because I wanted also to use it as a guitar amplifier or just as a speaker for actually using it to connect anything, like a piano, for example, or any other instrument that just uses or needs a playback, or also for, you want to do busking, for example, and then, yeah, I just have the speaker. It's not very good, but it's better than nothing. That was the idea. So then I bought the Soundcore 3. It sounded absolutely amazing compared to the Soundcore 1, quite as well. I would say it sounded pretty much like the UE Boom 2, which was, in my experience at least, the standard, apart from bigger speakers like the Marshall Kilburn, which kind of just blows you away because it sounds like a full-blown stereo. It also is almost as big as a full-blown stereo. The Soundcore 3 has actually, in the back, kind of a subwoofer. It's kind of a cutout where the sound just comes out. The Soundcore 1 doesn't have this, and the Soundcore 2 also obviously doesn't. But what the Soundcore 2 has compared to the Soundcore 3, it has an audio in. Now, it obviously also has Bluetooth. In terms of waterproofing, the Soundcore 3 is actually a little bit better, I guess, but there's also, so in on the Amazon comparison, it said that Soundcore 2 only had IPX5, but now it says IPX7, so yeah, well, it just also, IPX7 usually means, I think it means, it. I don't quite know. I also just realized that this is a little smaller than the Soundcore 3. The Soundcore 3, the Soundcore 3 was not fully rectangular. It was like a little bit bent where the subwoofer actually went out, and it's just quite a little bit thicker. This is more like the Soundcore 1, but just rubberized, more rubberized, which is nice. So now it's just one rectangle, basically. Not one rectangle, but what is actually the word for it? I don't quite know. So now, here's the Soundcore 2. Why? You now know why I bought this. I hope it's not as bad as the Soundcore 1. Kind of, I hope it's as good as the Soundcore 3. Soundcore 2, model A3105. It also has input 5 volts and 2 amps. It has these buttons, just like the Soundcore 1 and also the Soundcore 3. But the Soundcore 3 actually has, instead of a play button, it has like the Soundcore, new Soundcore logo. So actually, Anker branded Soundcore as its own brand. So now we have the power on. We have the minus, which is obviously for skipping songs, the other way around, and also for muting, not for muting, what is it actually called? Making music quieter and making music louder, playing back and pausing, and also taking calls, I guess, and the Bluetooth button. So now we just turn it on, and still I do have a second phone, therefore let's just turn on the Bluetooth by actually putting it on, turning it on. Ooh. The Soundcore 3 actually had another sound, which also, and it also already is in Bluetooth pairing mode, as you can see, by realizing it's searching for something. And also, I think it's automatically in the pairing mode. Usually then, if it turns on, obviously it's not automatically in the pairing mode, because usually it then already is paired. So let's just pull up my phone, and here it already is. It's a Soundcore 2, it's already pairing down below. It's not really sharp, but well, who cares? So now, you obviously, but Bluetooth pairing request, pair with Soundcore 2 is the question, and we just click on pair. And this was kind of crappy, maybe not the most ideal, but nah. Testing these devices obviously is always kind of a compromise because you don't want a copyright or have a copyright claim on your video, therefore, which is now tested with my own music. And I actually have my own music on Spotify, therefore I just take my own music, even though it is also copyrighted. But well, so now we just take something else. We just take, that's the break music for when I'm searching for music on Spotify. So let's actually first on put on some guitar. Why? Because this is kind of important to me as a reviewer, I would say, because that's actually something I would use this for, even though I do not have a guitar which I can plug in to the Soundcore 2 right now. But well, that's actually kind of a bummer, but I can connect my piano and try it, which I probably won't do on video. So let's just put on some blues, some instrumental blues, and see how it sounds. Well, it's not the most overwhelming yet. And that's the max volume. Tried the Soundcore 3 for the first time, I actually had some issues because I usually use it as a notebook stand. Now the problem is, the Soundcore 3 actually had too much bass, which means that my notebook just was kind of vibrating too much. I mean, you obviously can't just turn the volume down, it's not so much as a problem as just a side effect of the speaker being really good. This actually sounds kind of, at least from like just guessing now, because obviously you have to compare it side by side, which I can't because I already sent back the Soundcore 3. I could have kept it just for the sake of the video, but I just didn't want to manage my life around making this video. It's just something I have now and I'll just make a video about it. So therefore, let's just search for this other thing I also tried, and now let's just put it back. I am recording this on a Zoom H6. This is not with the internal phone mics. With the internal phone mics, it would sound a little bit crappier, but I do not absolutely know for sure that the Zoom H6 is connected. Sometimes it just doesn't work, but I hope you can kind of hear it. I'm putting it in front. Actually, the Soundcore 3 also sounded like more three-dimensional because it also had like this whole cut out in the back, and this one is just the front. Also, the UE Boom obviously is a 360 speaker because it just has one kind of column where there's no sound, but it's also kind of a problem because where do you put it? Because if you have a column like the UE Boom, you just put it somewhere and then it's just, yeah, standing there. It's nice, but I wouldn't just put it somewhere, and I like just the form, the simple form, the simplicity. And now let's just listen to the song again. I just realized there is a little bit of lag. So now, for those wondering, yeah, this is actually me on the picture. So now, let's just try another song. This is one, I just have a few songs as of right now on Spotify. I think the Soundcore 3 was a little bit louder, but the Soundcore 3 also is $50, this one is $30, so therefore it's like, how much is it actually? Let's just calculate it, it's 40% cheaper. So, well, I think it's quite a nice deal, because it's better than the Soundcore 1. It, obviously, this was why I sent back the Soundcore 3. I wouldn't have cared too much about the $20, but if I had a better speaker then, But I just wanted to have like one Bluetooth speaker, not a small Bluetooth speaker, not a big one, not a stereo. If I am traveling, I just I cannot take like all these things with me, like the Zoom H6 and also a full-blown stereo and also like 10 guitars. So therefore, I just am searching for something that I can also put in my backpack whenever hiking. Obviously, this is quite heavy, and then a JBL Go, if you really need a Bluetooth speaker, might be the better option. But for myself, I figured out that actually the notebook speakers are quite decent off the Spectra 15 I have. It's a 2019 version, and also the Galaxy S10 has quite decent speakers, so therefore I have like the normal devices, and then I have like the proper thing. And if I don't go with the proper thing, then I have a full-blown stereo. But if I have a full-blown stereo, then it's not a Bluetooth speaker anymore. If you want to have a full-blown stereo and the Bluetooth speaker at the same time, then just go with the Marshall Kilburn, because this just blows you away. It also has an at least the older version has an audio in, which is really nice, because then it looks like a guitar amp, but you also can just use it as a guitar amp, which is just nice. And I also tried it already. I also had like a workaround, which I posted on my music blog, where you actually connect your devices to a Zoom, basically a USB interface, and then you just, not a USB interface in this sense or in this function, but you just can connect the devices to the inputs of the Zoom, and then you just take the output, the line out, and just connect it to the Marshall in this scenario, and then you just have also a mic, for example, or a piano, and you are able to also put it out without only one single audio in. Without only using one single audio in. So now let's actually check out some other things I have on Bandcamp. Why? Because I just want to have. So on Bandcamp, I actually have a few kind of mastered songs. These other ones are kind of just acoustic. So therefore, I just go on there and let's just see. Yeah, it doesn't load it. I don't know why. Yeah, well, it's a different account. So I can only access it, obviously, on my normal Bandcamp account on my normal phone. And it just is not here, but I can play it, I think. So therefore, let's just search for it. I actually press stop right now. So now I just pick one of these, and I am not sure which one it is, but there are a few songs which, yeah. By the way, this is still at max volume, at least on my phone, and since the phone and the Bluetooth audio are usually connected, it's the same thing, it's the max volume. So the max volume obviously is not that good, but let's just take another one and just try. It's quite vibrating if you hold it, but it's not as vibrating as the SoundCloud 3. This is actually something now I made myself again, also using other music templates. All of these are things I made myself, but using other music loops as templates, basically. Well, I don't know what you care about. All right, I think this is a wrap, maybe just one under soon. This will have some bass dropping in. Well, it sounds quite nice. I will keep it. That's the decision. That's like my final decision. Also, it so this is my proper stereo I have at this place, and actually it just like fits on there very nicely, which is nice. And the final test doesn't work as, yes, it's perfect as a notebook stand. So it just works, and it's also because it's so rubberized, it just keeps the notebook very steady, which is nice. I tried like whenever you have this problem, whenever you are out and about and you are actually typing on your notebook, because this position is really not optimal in terms of spine and also in terms of looking, because you're actually looking down all the time. Therefore, I had something like a pencil case before, but obviously it's not that stable. And something that is just stable and also just doesn't change the form is nice. And also, this means you have your notebook anywhere you go. And then you just have your notebook stand, but your notebook stand is also your full-blown stereo. This means wherever you are, you basically have very nice audio, which means you can basically watch movies wherever you are because you always have this with you if you use it as a notebook stand. Or also just listen to music, or also just use it as an office speaker, or I don't know. Now, that's the final conclusion. And this also means if you have, for example, your notebook and you go to a lake to just chill out, then you also have your Bluetooth speaker because it's also your notebook stand. And that's just nice if you have devices that have multiple functionalities combined into one. So I keep it. That's, I guess, the decision. I think I just might link it in the description of this video. And yeah, maybe also linking the Soundcore 3, the Soundcore 1. They also are still available to buy. The Soundcore 1 is quite cheap these days, but I wouldn't necessarily buy the Soundcore 1. It's also a little bit bigger, I think. And this is just the nicest speaker of all these three, especially for me because of the audio input.